बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम। हम अपने प्रीवियस लेक्चर्स में कार्डियोवास्कुलर डिजीजेस के रिस्क फैक्टर्स को और उसके टाइप्स को डिटेल में डिस्कस कर चुके हैं। आज के लेक्चर में हम सारी ट्रीटमेंट स्ट्रेटजीज जो मेडिकल फील्ड में अपनाई जाती हैं कार्डियोवास्कुलर डिजीज को मैनेज करने के लिए, उन्हें डिस्कस करेंगे। कार्डियोवास्कुलर डिजीज़ की मैनेजमेंट के लिए दो तरह की थेरेपीज यूज़ होती हैं, आया वो फार्माकोलॉजिकल स्ट्रेटजीज हो सकती हैं या नॉन फार्माकोलॉजिकल स्ट्रेटजीज हो सकती हैं। नॉन फार्माकोलॉजिकल स्ट्रेटजीज विच आर बेसिकली द लाइफस्टाइल मॉडिफिकेशन, दे इंक्लूड रिस्ट्रिक्शन ऑफ सोडियम इनटेक, वेट लॉस, इंक्रीज कंजम्पशन ऑफ फाइबर वाया इंक्रीज डाइटरी इनटेक ऑफ फ्रूट्स एंड वेजिटेबल एंड इंक्लूडिंग लो फैट डेयरी एंड लीन मीट पोर्शंस and avoiding excess consumption of alcohol. We already have discussed that excess consumption of alcohol can worsen the disease sign and symptoms. However, moderate consumption of alcohol is associated with improved heart health. The impact of increased physical activity on improved heart health and outcomes have been identified by various researchers. If an individual is diabetic as well as hypertensive, then we reduce or restrict the sodium intake up to 1500 mg/day. By making certain changes in the lifestyle, we are aiming to improve the glycemic and lipid profile of a patient or a person who is at verge of developing cardiovascular disease. Here is a brief description how increased physical activity or exercise can improve your cardiovascular health. A person is physically active, there are certain chemicals released in his body that induces vasodilation. That means they causes the blood vessels to widen, which leads to increased blood and oxygen supply to the muscles and cells. Exercise and physical activity is also associated with increased mitochondrial biogenesis in adipose tissues, myocytes and cardiomyocytes, which are the cells of fats, skeletal muscles and heart muscles respectively. Lastly, the anti-inflammatory role of increased physical activity have a great importance in improving cardiovascular health. Non-pharmacological strategies यानी lifestyle modification उन patients के लिए best है जिनका blood pressure जो है वो 140/90 से कम है. Otherwise, जब इससे ज़्यादा blood pressure हो जाता है तो pharmacological therapy यानी कि drug administration बहुत ज़रूरी हो जाती है. The drug therapy involves certain antihypertensive drugs, most importantly angiotensin converting enzyme and angiotensin 2 receptor blockers. एंजियोटेंसिन रास मैकेनिज्म का एंजाइम है जो अल्टीमेटली वेजो कंस्ट्रिक्शन कराता है, यानी इंक्रीज्ड हार्ट रेट और इंक्रीज्ड ब्लड प्रेशर के साथ एसोसिएटेड होता है. इसी तरह एंजियोटेंसिन 2 रिसेप्टर ब्लॉकर्स हैं. अगर एंजियोटेंसिन 1-2 में यानी एक्टिव फॉर्म में कन्वर्ट हो भी गया है तो एंडोथेलियल सेल्स पे एक्ट तभी करेगा जब वो रिसेप्टर पे बाइंड करेगा, लेकिन ये मेडिकेशंस उस बाइंडिंग को ब्लॉक करती हैं, इनहिबिट करती हैं. बीटा ब्लॉकर्स वो ड्रग्स हैं जो आपकी बॉडी में एपिनेफ्रीन हार्मोन के एक्शन को रोकती हैं. व्हेन अ पर्सन इज स्ट्रेस्ड, द मेडुला ऑफ द एड्रिनल ग्लैंड लोकेटेड ऑन टॉप ऑफ द किडनीज रिलीजेस एपिनेफ्रीन, व्हिच नॉट ओनली इंक्रीज्ड हार्ट रेट एंड ब्लड प्रेशर बट ऑल्सो स्टिमुलेट्स शुगर मेटाबॉलिज्म. डायूरेटिक्स लोअर्स द ब्लड प्रेशर बाय फ्लशिंग आउट all the excess sodium or salts in your body, and they also causes or induces vasodilation. Calcium channel blockers inhibits the entry of calcium into cardiomyocytes, thus they are responsible for reducing the heart rate and blood pressure. When increased metabolic state or in a pregnant woman is complicated by the diabetes or hypertension, our goal is to lower the blood pressure or to maintain the blood pressure at least 130/80. The use of ACE inhibitors and related drugs during pregnancy is not recommended. Lifestyle intervention focus on medical nutrition therapy, increased physical activity, weight loss and smoking cessation. Basically, we are focusing on all the risk factors. By medical therapy, we mean the administration of drugs, and by nutrition therapy, we mean the tailored and individualized diet plan and dietary modification in one's diet. Diet therapy should be individualized and it should be tailored according to one's age, his type of diabetes, the type of drug administration, overall lipid profile, and and other associated medical conditions. Diet therapy, we recommend to reduce overall saturated and trans fat intake, which comes from animal sources usually, and we aim to increase the consumption of omega-3 fatty acids and increase fiber consumption. Now we will discuss the treatment recommendations and goals to manage the hyperlipidemia or dyslipidemia. Of lipid profile in an individual who has recently been diagnosed with the CVD or who is 40 or above is very important. We already have discussed the importance of making lifestyle modification and reducing saturated and trans fat intake and increased consumption of omega-3 fatty acids. Here is an additional point, which is increased consumption of phytosterols. Phytosterols basically are the plant sterols or plant cholesterol, which is structurally similar to that of the cholesterol synthesized in our liver. And when consumed, it compete with the absorption of cholesterol in our intestine, thus help lowering the total cholesterol level in our body. Increased triglyceride levels and reduced HDL cholesterol in blood can have adverse outcomes and can be managed by making certain lifestyle modification in one. However, if the fasting triglycerides crosses the borderline, then the medical nutrition therapy should be introduced. Statins are basically lipid or cholesterol lowering drugs. Mode of action by which statin lowers the total cholesterol in our body is that they inhibit the HMG coreductase enzyme, which is responsible for the synthesis of cholesterol in our liver. Dietary factors have already been recognized as an important factor in the development of cardiovascular diseases if other medical or metabolic defects are not present. It has also been observed that dietary behaviors which are not healthy are usually accompanied by other unhealthy habits such as reduced physical activity and smoking. Similarly, research has also proved that unhealthy dietary practices such as increased consumption of saturated fats, salts, refined carbohydrates, and reduced fruits and vegetable consumption, they tend to cluster. So we conclude that diet is linked with the risk factors of cardiovascular diseases like increased body weight, central obesity, dyslipidemia, increased blood pressure, or thrombotic mechanism, etc.